Hello friends, I am Dr. Vivek Jain, Faculty of Preventive and Social Medicine and author of the book Review of PSM including Biostatistics. As all of us know, a big pandemic globally of coronavirus has been going on in majority countries of the world since January 2020. So many students have been asking me questions regularly about this disease. Sir, which kind of question we can expect in the exam? Will incubation period be asked from PSM? Will epidemiology be asked in more detail in PSM? Should I expect questions from prevention or should I expect questions from biomedical waste management related to this disease? So what I've tried to do, I've tried to convert all the important facts into multiple choice questions related to this disease. So what we'll do is we'll go through this topic one by one and try to discuss what important aspects could be asked in your forthcoming examinations. So let us start with the first question. Infectious disease caused by the most recently discovered coronavirus in December 2019 is currently known as, what is the current name of this disease? Is it IBV? Is it Middle East Respiratory Syndrome MERS, COVID-19 or Swine Acute Diarrhea Syndrome Coronavirus? Very right, it is currently known as COVID-19. Now friends, when we look at this disease, this COVID-19 is actually an abbreviation if you look. This is coronavirus disease of the year 2019. This name COVID-19 was given by World Health Organization on 11th of February 2020. Much before that, that is on 7th January 2020, this disease or organism was first known as novel coronavirus. And subsequently, it was renamed as SARS-CoV-2. Moving to the second question, what was the origin for the recent most outbreak of this coronavirus COVID-2019 disease? Was it Tokyo in Japan, Wuhan in China, Venice in Italy or Pune in Maharashtra? Yes, it was Wuhan in Hubei province of China. From Wuhan in Hubei province of China, on 12th of December 2019, first case was reported. And by the end of December, it grew to a large number of cases who were subsequently reported to the WHO China office as pneumonia of unknown etiology. On this fact itself is based our third question. Health authorities alerted 27 cases of pneumonia of unknown etiology to WHO China office on which date? Later, of course, it was designated as novel coronavirus. This date was the last day of the year. That is 31st of December 2019. Friends, also remember the date 30th of January 2020 because it was on this date that this disease was declared a public health emergency of international concern. Friends, in fact, on this very date itself, 30th of January 2020, first case of coronavirus was reported in India in the state of Kerala. Moving to the next question, friends, all of you know, most of our examination bodies are very fond of asking dates through PSM. Like you must have seen the question, what was the date of global eradication of smallpox? It was 8th of May 1980. Similarly, they can ask you, COVID-19 disease has recently been declared pandemic by WHO. So on which date this global pandemic declaration was done? That was 11th of March 2020. Please remember, since its appearance, this global pandemic has been able to reach 213 countries and close to 5 million people are affected with 0.3 million deaths. Moving further, what is the incubation period of this COVID-19 disease? Friends, first you tell me, what is the incubation period? It is time period or gap between entry of organism in human body till appearance of first sign or symptom. For the disease COVID-19, it is quite variable and it lies between 2 to 14 days. When we look at Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India, it was found in India based on studies that the incubation period of this disease is almost similar. 1 to 12.5 days with a median of 5 to 6 days of incubation. After incubation period, let's look at what are the established modes of transmission. So question may come like this. established modes of transmission of coronavirus COVID-19 disease include all except bloodborne, contact, fomites, respiratory droplets. Friends, definitely it is a disease which is spreading through contact, fomites, and respiratory droplets. Therefore, the answer to this question is it is not a bloodborne infection. Now, beside these three established routes of transmission, studies were carried out, but it has not been established conclusively whether fecal route is a route of transmission. Similarly, food consumption has not been found to be an established route of transmission for this disease as of yet. Moving further, if you look for this coronavirus disease, what is the estimated overall case fatality rate globally? Now, although it varies a lot, when I say it varies a lot, it implies it has been recorded in studies very low, only 0.2% in the country Germany, to a very high value of 7.7% in Italy. So overall, globally, if you look as of now, the estimated overall case fatality rate has been found to be 2 to 4%. Even in our country, as at the time of recording this video, case fatality rate was around 3.4%. Now it has been found in some particular group of populations, this case fatality rate has been recorded to be higher. So what are these particular group of people in which this disease has high CFR? This include, it has been found higher age is more associated with fatality in COVID-19. In fact, if you look at the global data, people above the age of 65 years comprise of almost 3/4 of the total deaths due to this disease globally. Sex-wise also, males have shown predominance in this disease. Almost 60% plus cases have been reported from male sex. And also, the mortality is greatly enhanced if the case is having any pre-existing comorbidity. In fact, friends, our next question is based on these comorbidities only which affect this coronavirus disease. So, question is, comorbidities that increase the risk of death among COVID-19 cases include all of the following except. So, does it include malaria, cardiovascular disease, diabetes mellitus, or hypertension? Very right, cardiovascular disease, diabetes mellitus, hypertension are known comorbidities which increase the risk of death. So answer to this question is disease malaria does not increase the risk of death in COVID-19 patients per se. Friends, if you look at global data currently, which comorbidity has highest risk of disease in COVID-19? Number one is cardiovascular disease. Number two is diabetes mellitus. Number three is chronic respiratory disease. Number four is hypertension. And number five is carcinoma or cancers. Let's move to next question. What is the nodal laboratory which is designated for coronavirus testing in India? It is, very right, NIV, National Institute of Virology in Pune. Friends, when we look at NIV Pune for COVID-19, it is credited with discovery or development of first antibody testing kit, that is ELISA kit, in India. Moving to next question, which type of epidemic curve is shown by COVID-19 currently? Is it single exposure point source, multiple exposure point source, or propagative? Friends, if you look in different parts of the world, it is showing different types of time distribution of the disease in form of epidemics. In some parts, you have found at some particular geographical location, there is a single exposure point source epidemic. There is a sudden rise in number of cases because no one is having any immunity whatsoever against this COVID disease. And then the disease has been declining also suddenly. But in some other parts of the same district, state, country or world, you will see a curve like this because there is repeated multiple or continuous exposure where a single person is trying to give repeated infection to the same community again, again and again. So secondary waves are produced. But after all, it is a respiratory disease. So already it has started occurring, and ultimately COVID-19 is going to show, because it is a respiratory disease, person to person transmission, slow rise, slow fall, plateau in between, propagated type of epidemic ultimately. So this disease is showing all these three subtypes of epidemics currently. Let's move further. See, friends, you must have seen this photograph in newspapers or news media known as walk-through disinfectant tunnels, where a person is asked to go through this tunnel and we can disinfect him so that he is rendered non-infectious to others. So a very common question which they could ask is, what is the used or the commonly used disinfectant in walk-through disinfectant tunnels for COVID-19 disease? Is it 5% Cresol? Is it Cetrimide? 1% sodium hypochlorite or hydrogen peroxide? Very right, it is 1% sodium hypochlorite solution. Concentration in different parts of the world may be listed differently, but sodium hypochlorite is the commonest used disinfectant for coronavirus disease. Now, if you look, sodium hypochlorite could be used for indoors areas, it could be used for high contact surfaces, and it could also be used for metallic surfaces. But for metallic surfaces, 70% alcohol is also used in disinfection. Let's look at next question. Government of India, through Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, have launched a COVID-19 tracking mobile app or mobile application, which has been developed by National Informatics Center. What is the name of this mobile application or mobile app? That is known as Arogya Setu. All of you should definitely download this app if you have not downloaded it till now. Now, what is the benefit of downloading this app by each and every citizen of our country? It has multiple benefits. Number one, it is used to generate awareness among the general population. Number two, it connects population directly to the health services and the health system of the country. Number three, it helps in risk assessment, especially the self-risk assessment also. A questionnaire, a tool is present in the app by which you can analyze, are you at risk of coronavirus disease currently? Number four, it tells you the cases update in the country. And number five, it also tells you how many cases are present in your vicinity right now. Within 500 meters, how many positive cases are there? Within 1 kilometer, within 2 kilometer, within 5 kilometer, and within 10 kilometer range, how many positive cases are currently present? How many people have currently got themselves tested in the following distance range from the location of your mobile? This is the logo which is being used for this Arogya Setu mobile app developed indigenously in India. So friends, continuing with the initiation and efforts of Government of India, a toll-free number 24/7 All India National Helpline number for COVID-19 has been launched by Government of India. That number you must know is 1075. So 1075 is the major national helpline number for any query or any help required related to coronavirus. Now friends, coming to an important subsection of COVID-19 epidemiology related to PSN is biomedical waste management disposal. Biomedical waste management guidelines have been issued separately for this COVID-19 disease. Please remember, what guidelines I am discussing is given by or has been given by CPCB, Central Pollution Control Board of India. These guidelines may vary slightly among few state to state or even among institution to institution. So I am telling you the generalized guidelines. Look at the first question. COVID-19 biomedical waste guidelines say N95 mask, head or cover cap, shoe cover, disposable linen gown, they should be disposed in which of the following color-coded biomedical waste management bag? Is it yellow bag, red bag, white container or blue bag? Very right, that is yellow bag. So that is used for disposal of these important biomedical waste. Similarly, if you look, same guidelines by CPCB say goggles, face shield, splash proof apron, plastic overall, hazmat suit, nitrile gloves, they should be disposed in, yes, red bag of biomedical waste management. Now friends, please remember, as I was telling you earlier, in many institutions they are using only yellow bag for disposal of all these biomedical waste. In few institutions they may be using only red bag for disposal of biomedical waste related to COVID-19. But what is more important is, any bag that you are using, it should be appropriately labeled as COVID-19 biomedical waste for disposal. Third question related to biomedical waste, viral transport media, plastic vials, vacuum containers, append of tubes, plastic cryo vials and pipette tubes, they should be disposed in which of the following? That is again red bag. Now coming to a pure epidemiology question. Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India recommended that what should be the duration of quarantine for COVID-19 disease, and based on available information, it is recommended for how many days, weeks or months from the time of exposure? Very right, the duration of quarantine for COVID-19 has been recommended to be up to 14 days from the time of exposure. The major purpose of applying this quarantine is to reduce the transmission of disease in our community and the country. And how is this quarantine going to work? It will work by two major mechanisms or principles. Number one, it will help in separation and monitoring of contacts. And number two, it will help us demarcate suspects of this disease correctly. Friends, you must have seen one of the most important things related to COVID-19 for frontline health workers, including doctors in the country, has been PPE, that is personal protective equipment, which give a high degree of protection against this disease. So question may be asked that PPE for this COVID-19 disease actually includes all except, it does not include, or you can say it does not include, hand sanitizer with 40% alcohol, coverall gowns, head cover, shoe cover, gloves, goggles, face shield, mask. So what is not included in PPE is hand sanitizer with 40% alcohol. That is not PPE. That is actually a type of disinfection used in prevention and control of COVID-19. Now friends, when we look at the other three choices, let's look at important features. First, we look at coverall gowns along with head cover, shoe cover. This is believed to provide 360 degree protection to the health personnel using them. When we look at gloves, studies have shown nitrile gloves are better than latex gloves. It's not just related to energy, but it is also related to the chemical which is used, the protection which it gives. And when we look at masks, two major types are there. Number one, triple layer medical mask, and number two, N95 respirator mask. Which of the following is true regarding filtration capacity of mask? Now friends, when you look at this FFP1, FFP2, FFP3, this is actually a classification which has been given by European Union. What is this FFP? FFP is filtration face piece divided into three categories. FFP1, FFP2, FFP3, where their filtration capacities are minimum 80%, 94% and 98%. So answer is all of the above, where there are three categories of these FFPs, 1, 2 and 3 as shown in the photographs respectively. Friends, let's move further. ICMR Delhi and National Institute of Virology Pune has developed an indigenous ELISA test kit for COVID-19 antibody. And this test kit is known as by the name of Kavach ELISA. Friends, you must know three things regarding this Kavach ELISA antibody detection test. Number one point you should know, it has been developed by isolating virus from Indian individuals. Number two, it is going to be used for surveillance purposes. A sero survey is going to be undertaken among 24,000 individuals in 69 districts of the country. And this survey will be taken or done at household level. And third thing, we must not forget, this Kavach ELISA is only a surveillance kit. The mainstay of diagnosis in India still remains real-time PCR, that is RT-PCR test. Friends, like Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp, Telegram and email, I now request you to join me on YouTube channel also. Kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel, which is by my name, Dr. Vivek Jain. And what I will do is, I'll keep on updating or keep on uploading videos on this channel for few viewing of all the students. There will be regular updates, regular academic videos, regular MCQ discussion videos, regular exam discussions videos on this channel. So press the notification link and keep on getting regular updates through this channel. Otherwise, beyond this, you can also connect to me through my mobile video lecture app, through my website, email. You can ask any query or question. WhatsApp number given on the screen will also help us connect faster. Or you can like my Facebook page, Dr. Vivek Jain PSM Updates, where all updates, the day they appear, I update simultaneously on all the social media platforms. Telegram also, you can join my group, Dr. Vivek Jain PSM. I am also available on Instagram as Vivek Jain PSM. Friends, you can download my PSM mobile video lecture app, which has complete video lectures for the complete course of PSM. Either through Android, you can get it, or if you are having iOS platform, you can get it for the Play Store. Friends, thank you. I wish you all the best for the grand success you are going to get in forthcoming examinations.